Hello everyone. Today we will again go through the subject mechatronics, in which we will be dealing today with the point named electrical drives. So what are electrical drives? Before that we will go with the question, what are drives? Okay. So, the systems employed for motion control are called drives. Okay. So, drives basically we are going to use to control different motions in the system. It may employ any of prime movers such as diesel engines or petrol engines or gas turbines or steam turbines, steam engines, hydraulic motors and electrical motors, for supplying mechanical energy for motion control. So basically the energy supplied from the control of motion will be from any of these prime movers. And here our interest is in electrical drives. So drives employing electric motors are called as electrical drives. So the drives which we are going to use here will be controlled or employed with electrical motors. Parts of electrical drives. So we are having a block diagram here in which we can go through the different parts of an electrical drive. So source, then power modulator, motor and load. Okay, again for closed loop operation we need a sensing unit, and we need to employ a control unit for controlling a power modulator, and the control unit will be given an input command. So these are different components of an electric drive. Let's go through these points, the important points from this diagram. So firstly, the power modulator. The power modulator regulates the output power of a source. It controls the power from the source to the motor in such a manner that motor transmits the speed or torque characteristics required by the load. During the transient operations like starting, braking and speed reversing, the excessive current drawn from the source. This excessive current drawn from the source may overload it or may cause a voltage drop. Hence, the power modulator restricts the source and the motor current. The power modulator converts the energy according to the requirement of motor. For example, if the source is DC and an induction motor is used, then power modulator converts DC into AC, that is direct current into alternate current. It also selects the mode of operation of a motor like motoring or braking. Okay. So this was regarding the power modulator. The next is control unit. The control unit controls the power modulator, which operates at small voltage and power levels. The control unit also operates the power modulator as desired. It also generates the commands for the protection of power modulator and motor. An input command signal which adjusts the operating point of the drive from an input to the control unit. Next is sensing unit. It senses the certain drive parameters like motor current and speed. It mainly is required either for protection of the system or for the closed loop operation. As I already mentioned that if we need a closed loop operation so that output can also be monitored, then we need to incorporate a sensing unit. So it will continuously sense the output coming from the motor, which may be the current, motor current or the speed of the motor, and accordingly it will be given to the control unit, and control unit will again control the output of modulator, which will control again the motor. Likewise, the closed loop operation also is possible here with the help of the sensing unit. So basically these are the components which are used in the electric drive. So next point, that is advantages of electric drives. So what are the different advantages of an electric drive? These are mentioned here. First, the electrical drives are available in a wide range of torque, speed and power. They are adaptable to almost any operating conditions such as explosive environment or a radioactive environment, or if it is submerged in liquids, vertical mounting and so on. So various different conditions, operating conditions can be handled by these electric drives. The electrical drive does not pollute the environment. So basically in electric drive, all the components are electric components. So definitely there will not be any pollution like air pollution or water pollution, which may be the case in other kind of drives. Say if you use diesel engine or petrol engine as a prime mover for the drive, then definitely because of the combustion of the fuel like diesel or petrol, there will be exhaust gas will be generated, which can pollute the air by giving out different poisonous gases like carbon monoxide and sulfur dioxide, etc. So this case is not with the electric drives, because electrical drives are only operated by using electric current from the source, and that is a clean source of energy. Electricity is the clean source of energy, so that can be called as it will not pollute the environment. Basically, then it can operate in all four quadrants of the speed torque plane. It can be started instantly and can immediately be fully loaded. That is, there is no need to refuel or warm up the motor. Like again, if we compare with the conventional or rather diesel engine or petrol engine like prime movers and electric motors, then if diesel or petrol gets exhausted, we need to refuel the system and then again we need to start the system for the operation. Here there is no such need. As electric current is available or electricity is available, we can instantly start the system. Again, for fully loading of a few prime mover like diesel petrol engines, we need to go for warm up. Here it is not the case. As we give the current to the motor or drive, it will directly start working at full load. So these are advantages of electric drives over the mechanical drives. They have flexible control characteristics and can be employed to automatically control the drive. Then, because of these advantages, the mechanical energy already available from a non-electrical prime mover sometimes first converted into electrical energy and by a generator and back to the mechanical energy by an electric motor. Electrical link thus provides between the non-electrical prime movers and the load impact to the drive flexible control characteristics. So these are few advantages of electric drives. Let's again go through the few disadvantages of electric drives also. The power failure completely disables the whole of the system. So we know the basic source for the running of the electric drive is electricity. So when there is a power failure, the complete system will come to an halt as or get disabled, as there is no power, electricity or no electricity. So we need to again wait for power to again restart the system. So that is one of the main disadvantages. Then the application of a drive is limited because it cannot be used in a place where the power supply is not available. Again, it is again dependent on the first disadvantage, that if there is no power supply available at any place or there is no electricity at any place, we cannot go for these drives. We need to go for mechanical drives only, or non-electrical prime movers can be employed there. And it can cause noise pollution. Now this is regarding one of the type of pollutions. as in advantage we have gone through that there will not be any air or water pollution, but it can cause noise pollution. So if the motor, electric motor used in a drive is not properly maintained, then there are chances of causing noise pollution because of running of that motor. Okay, so it can cause, okay, noise pollution. Then the initial cost of the system is high, as we are going to use different electric components, definitely the cost is going to increase. That initial cost is going to increase, also running cost will be there. So these are a few disadvantages. Then we will go for the classification of electric drives. Generally, the electric drives are classified into three categories: group drives, individual drive, and multimotor drive. The first, that is group drive. If several group of mechanisms or machines are organized on the one shaft and driven or actuated by one motor, the system is called as a group drive or shaft drive. So in this type, we are having only one motor and all the other mechanisms or machines which are going to be driven by using motor will be connected through belts or pulleys to a single shaft of the single motor. That is a group drive. The advantage is it is most economical because we are going to use only one motor, so it will be obviously economical. Disadvantages: any fault that occurs in driving motor renders all the driving equipment idle. This means if because of any problem occurred, say motor gets stopped, then all the systems connected to the motor are going to come to a stop and the whole system will be impacted. So that is the major disadvantage. As we are going to use only one motor, all the machines connected to this motor are going to stop. Then efficiency is low because losses occurring in energy transmitting mechanisms. As we are going to transmit the energy from single motor to different machines connected through belts or pulleys or gear drives, definitely there will be power losses. And again, lastly, not safe to operate. Also, noise level at the working spot will be high. As we are going to connect different machines to a single motor, there are chances, there may be a chance that safety may be subsided somewhere. Again, noise level also are going to increase as different machines will be located nearby the other ones. Okay, so these are the group drives. Next is individual drive. If a single motor is used to drive or actuate a given mechanism, it does all the jobs connected with this load, the drive is called as an individual drive. That is, single motor is used for a single machine or a mechanism. So particular mechanism is going to use a single motor. So all the machines will be having their own motors. So all the operations connected with operating a lathe may be performed by using single motor. So we know a lathe machine has a single motor and all operations which we do on lathe machine can be performed by that single motor only. The disadvantage is power losses is going to occur. The next is multimotor drive. Each operations of the mechanism is taken care of by a separate drive motor. Okay, that is, separate motors are provided for actuating different parts of a driven mechanism. So in a single mechanism, there may be different parts are need to be actuated differently. There each part will get separate motor. Like suppose we know the welding or the spray painting robotic arms are there in the industry. So for each axis rotation like X, Y, Z, we need to rotate that arm in all the three axes for proper welding or painting of any component. So separate motor for each axis will be provided to that robotic arm. So for rotation in Z direction, for rotation in X direction, rather X axis, that is for rotation around the Z axis, X axis and Y axis, three different motors are being used in that robotic arm. The system contains several individual drives, each of which is used to operate its own mechanism, right? So that is multi-motor drive. Advantages: each machine is driven by a separate motor and it can be run or stopped as desired. So as each mechanism has its own motor, if some of the mechanism is not needed for any operation, we can stop it, the stop that motor, and that operation is also stopped. Other system is going to not going to be any affected by it. Then machines not required can be shut down and also replaced with a minimum of dislocation. Suppose any machine may get some error, then that only that machine can be stopped and maintained or repaired. There is a flexibility in the installation of different machines, so we can install machines anywhere we want, or we can use ample amount of space for installation of machines, which is not the case with the group drive. In case of motor fault, only its connected machine will stop, whereas other will continue working undisturbed. Okay, so as every mechanism is going to use its own motor, the only part which is a problem, that can be stopped and maintained, other will be continuing. Absence of belt and line shafts greatly reduce the risk of accidents to the operating personnel. As we have seen in group drives, we need belts or pulleys or gears or shaft. So there are chances of accidents because of those belts and pulleys and gear drives. So that is avoided here in multi-motor drive. There in the group drive, that is the disadvantage of the system, that there may be a risk of accident. And disadvantage of this drive is high initial cost. Definitely we are going to use number of motors here, so multi-motor drive will be having high cost. Okay, the next point is selection of motor for particular application. So we are going to discuss only different criteria based on which we can select a motor for different applications. So the criteria are economical operation. So can work continuously and take place of two or more laborers. So that is economical operation. Then dependable, always ready to work. Efficient, efficiency ranges from 65 to 95%. Long life, 20 to 30 years with the proper care. Then ease of operation, special skills are not required for operating the motors. Then safety, if properly used, it is very safe. Low service requirement, minimum amount of attention is required. Then quiet operation, when properly applied and installed, it will be a quiet operation, less noisy or no noise. Automation, can be automatically and remotely controlled. Then adaptable, light, compact and easily moved, so we can directly adapt. And available, it is available throughout the country, standard basis sizes and wiring equipment are also available. So these are the different criteria based on which we can go for electrical drives in the operation, instead of going for different non-electrical prime movers or drives. So basically this was regarding the definition of electric drives, then its advantages, disadvantages, different types and selection criteria of electric drives. So thank you.